The Ripon Tiger Sports Network welcomes to another broadcast of Ripon Tiger Sports on the Ripon Channel, 93.1 FM and AM 1600 WRPM, your hometown station. I'm Howard Hansen along with Marty Ernzer, and tonight we bring you boys basketball. The Tiger boys tonight are hosting the Vikings from WLA. And with that, I want to bring in Marty Ernzer. And Marty, glad, hope you had a good holiday.
Yep.
And before we get talking about this game, let's talk a little bit about the last outing by the Tigers when they played Berlin.
Yeah, that was way back last year on the 18th of December. Ripon hosted Berlin. First half, it was Berlin really dictating the pace of the game. Ripon came back, started playing with a more higher energy defensively, and they kind of got their offense going. They won going away. That same night in the, around the conference, you had Kettle Moraine Lutheran losing, being upset by Kewaskum. And at that time, Kewaskum was in second. The Tigers were in third. And now that has been flip-flopped so that Plymouth, undefeated in conference, now is a game ahead of Ripon. And then Kettle Moraine Lutheran is in third. The remaining teams in the league all have losing records. That's not to say that some of them, like a Kewaskum and even a Campbellsport, can't any given night step up and beat any of the top three teams. So that's what's been going on there. On the 22nd, that game was another non-conference scheduled game with Chilton. Didn't materialize. There were some COVID issues on the Chilton side of things, so they just canceled that game on the 22nd. So it's been 18 days since the 18th of December that the Tigers have put on their sneakers and prepared to play a sanctioned game finally again.
And that can really kind of be a double-edged sword. You can either, that rest could really help you, or not being playing can kind of cause you to be a little sluggish coming out of the gate tonight.
Yeah, most coaches will tell you they'd like to have a routine, and part of that routine is some constant play, you know, a couple games a week at least. So you don't get that. Ripon's not the only victim that falls to that during the holiday season. So what they are going to do, speaking with Coach Brooks, is they have a chance now coming up of really, in his words, he's really pleased with a couple of the practices of late. Good focus, high energy, decent leadership. And so now playing a winless WLA team tonight at 0-5 overall, 0-4 in conference play, a member of the Flyway Conference. They're working on some new stuff. So we're going to see. It'll be interesting because he didn't say specifically what they've been doing. I don't even know if it's offensive or defensive. So we'll see some new, not tricks, but some new,
new
style.
Looks.
Some new looks by the Tigers tonight.
Well, you know, and talking about WLA's record, though, that's kind of misguided because I got a chance to call a game with them against Amro, and they played extremely well. It went to overtime, and Amro just squeaked that one out. So they are a very capable team.
Yeah, they are losing on the average by 9 points. Their crosstown rival in the Holy Wars was St. Mary Springs.
Yeah.
They blistered them by 16. But even with that factored in there, they're still losing their games by an average of single digits.
Yep.
Which you're right. So they're competitive. They just haven't been able to get that first W.
Well, and you also have to watch out for them. You have to watch out for number four, Ethan Cole.
Yeah.
He is a barn burner, and he's averaging, you said, 25 a game?
Yeah, same as his counterpart, the super sophomore for Ripon, Riley Brooks. They both average 25 and change per contest. So that's always fun.
Yeah.
Just like the Lewards game when we saw Rudinger, who had 26 at the half. In that crazy game on that Saturday afternoon a month ago.
We should just let those two play one-on-one and call it a game.
Yeah, well, it might be interesting. Looking at diving into those numbers with regards to WLA, what is so glaring is they team averages or shoots 33% from the floor. The opponent shoots on average 57% from the floor. You just can't win.
No.
Giving up double-digit percentages on production offensively. That's hard to do. Ripon, by the way, shoots 46% from the floor. so far this season. And both teams shoot 66 and 68% from the free throw line. When we break it down, Howard, and I'll go really quick here, you got WLA, and their top three scorers shoot on average 39, 37, and 31% from the floor. Conversely, Ripon, their top three scorers, they shoot 58, 51, and 42% from the floor. And there you have it.
Another big difference.
Big difference.
In the two teams there. So,
yeah.
All right. Well, we'll turn around and be back with the starting lineups and the national anthem in 3 minutes. Okay, I thought he was going to do that read-in, but okay, anytime you want to bring us in. And now the starting lineups for the Winnebago Lutheran Academy Vikings. Number three, a 5'10 junior, Aiden Barr. Number four, a 6'1 junior, Ethan Cole. Number 14, a 6'1 freshman, Noah Ginsler. Number 22, a 6'4 senior, Connor Lick. And number 34, a 6'2 senior, Tyler Kuski. They are under the head coaching direction of Marty Nell and Craig Schwartz.
Boy, I like that coach's first name.
You should. I bet you'd get a kick out of that one. Now for your Ripon Tigers. Number two, a 5'8 junior, Spencer Schultz. Number five, a 6 foot senior, Garrett Jennings. Number 10, a 6'3 sophomore, Riley Brooks. Number 15, a 6'4 senior, Grant Schneider. And number 21, a 6'4 junior, Kai Agamite. The Tigers are under the head coaching direction of Steve Brooks. Marty, your thoughts before we tip off here?
Yeah, I think Ripon's been playing some pretty good basketball even in that this season, actually, in the games that I've had the pleasure of calling and seeing. And so I think it's important when you're playing an opponent without a win, you let them know early that you're going to be in charge of the game. So let's see if Ripon comes out with some energy.
Now turn around, and Winnebago Lutheran got the ball. No tip tonight. They're moving it around on the top. That's Cole. Dishes it off down to Barr. Back to Cole for the long three-pointer from the top. He's off to the left, and it will be Tiger ball.
Hey, that closeout on that shooter, Cole, just now, you got to close out better, in my opinion. The point being, it was a token closeout, and he knew it, and that's why he took the shot.
Exactly, very slow. Riley Brooks from the top of the key, little turnaround jumper, can't get that one to go. Ball's kicked around, slipped around, and brought it, picked up by the Tigers. Schultz,
trouble.
Yeah. Too many steps there by Spencer Schultz.
Too bad. Good effort on the going to the floor for the Tigers.
Great effort by both teams going for that ball. So Vikings will bring it up court. That'll be Barr as he's working the right side, looking to drive, goes in. Schneider tries to defend him. Can't do anything about it as it drops in for the first 2 points of the ball game.
A nice job by Barr in the blow by to avoid the charge on the help defense.
Brooks on top, gets it over to Jennings. Jennings feeds down underneath to Schneider. Schneider goes down the baseline, puts it up and in for the first two for the Tigers, and we're tied at two with 17 to go.
Schneider
in the first half. Sorry.
The big bear, just nice move for the left.
Great baseline move for him there. Barr working around the left side. He'll dish that off. Back on top. Kinsler kicks it to Barr. Barr puts it up the corner, misses it, and the rebound comes down to the Tigers. Brooks pushes it up quick, can't get it to go. Rebound comes back out and picked up by Schultz. Over to Brooks down the left side.
Yeah, they're both teams are running.
And Brooks puts up the three-pointer, gives the Tigers the 5-2 lead. I like that matchup, Ethan Cole against Riley Brooks.
That was too easy.
Barr bringing it up, kicks it back outside. Driving the lane, puts it up, and a big block by the Bear.
Nice job.
Kinsler driving, and Schneider did a nice job. Went straight up and just swatted it away.
Boy, if you talk about who's got your six and who's your wingman, what a great job.
Zachary Pusma checks in for WLA. Falls in to Kuski. Moving it around there on top. Over to Barr. Barr looking to drive. Gets the floater up. Can't get it to go as it bounces off the iron. Garrett Jennings brings down that rebound. Takes it up the right side. Looking. Uses the glass and drops it in. Two for Jennings.
This Tiger team loves to run.
Well, take advantage of the athleticism there. As Barr brings it up. He fakes. Goes underneath. Little stutter step not called here. Cole with it, drives the lane, gets the floater to go.
Yeah, he switched hands. I don't know if he's a left-handed shooter yet. I don't think he is.
We will find out as it goes. Schneider feeds it into the corner. Down to Agamite, and they're going to call the foul as he lowers the shoulder.
Yeah, he hit him with his head. I don't know why he just didn't take the jump shot. As soon as he received the pass from his teammate, there was 8 feet between him and the defender. And then he took the dribble into the teeth of the defense and got called for the headbutt.
7-4 is the score here. Barr from up on top. Nothing but net for the three there. Gives Aiden Barr 5. Scores tied at 7. Little floater put up there by Schultz. Can't get it to go. Rebound brought down by Cole. Off to the right side, driving in the lane, feeds down inside, and they're going to call a block. A foul.
Now go on 21 for the Tigers. Agamite.
That'll be his. His second foul right away, so we'll have to keep an eye on that.
Yeah, I mean, just what? He got the charge and then now the reach on the shot.
And Zachary Pusma puts in the first.
That's a big second foul against the Tigers this early in the game. He does a lot of things for the team.
He's a strong rebounder, that's for sure.
He does everything.
Second one is on its way. That's off the front of the iron, and that rebound is pulled down by Brooks. He'll push it up, working up the left side, goes down, fakes, gets Cole off balance, and we're going to get a foul on Jennings over the back. That'll be his first, third team foul on the Tigers. 8-7 WLA with the lead here.
Ripon's going to have to tighten up their defense here, be a little more selective on their aggressiveness, because right now they're over the back or they're reaching.
Barr drives the lane, gets it high and over the top of Schneider, and gets 2 points for him, gives him 7.
You got to force Barr to his left. We haven't seen him go to his left yet, and I want to see if he can. Pick and roll.
Schneider underneath, can't finish it off, gets his own rebound, puts it up and in. Makes it 10-9. Cole with it down. Kicks it back out. Kinsler puts up 3. Noah Kinsler with his first basket of the game is a 3-pointer.
WLA heating up offensively here.
Schultz drives the baseline, tries going up and draws the foul. Foul being called. Just a matter of who they're going to call that on.
Foul's being called.
Petty play by Schultz, the junior guard for the Tigers. I think he kind of knew he wasn't going to get that ball off between those tall trees. Was able to, he called the foul before that. I'm kind of surprised. Looked like a reverse layup attempt to me.
Brandon Carlson checks in for the Tigers. We get the ball in. Brooks from on top of the key gets that one to drop.
Brooks two for the Tigers.
The Tigers a little closer, 13-11. Tigers trailing.
How many times has Brooks done that move, I'll bet you, at home?
Forever. And there's a rare air ball by Cole. And there's a turnover there. Ball will go to the Tigers.
Ripon trailing by two here. Just under 14 minutes remaining in the first half.
Jennings bringing it up, dishes it off to Brooks. Brooks with a little spin move again, and that is smooth.
He's got his rhythm going.
We're tied at 13, 13-28 to go here in the first half. Barr with it, little shake and bake there, kicks it outside. And a long air ball by Ginsler and brought down by Schneider. Tigers push up. Schneider, a little fake there, goes to the basket, can't get it to go. Rebound brought down by Kuzma.
Big guy took it coast to coast.
You gotta like that one.
He wanted it bad.
Into the paint. Drives Kuski and couldn't get that one to drop. Here comes Brooks. That's a little spin move off balance. Can't get it to go. Schneider with a big bear paw cleaning the glass underneath. And they're going to call a foul.
He was pinned against the baseline by three blue WLA Viking jerseys. And he got bailed out with the official's whistle. Saved a timeout by Coach Brooks.
And all the Vikings had to do was just stand there, and eventually he couldn't get out. Brooks from way downtown off the front of the island. And brought down by Pusma for the rebound. Cole looking to fake. He comes around. Nice little spin move for him. Can't get it to go. And Carlson will pick up his first foul. That'll be the fourth foul on the Tigers.
Coming on and shooting is Ethan Cole for the Vikings.
Drive with confidence all season long. Get ready for your next road trip adventure with Goodyear Tires from Cliff's Tire and Battery, downtown Ripon. And the first one is missed there. As Ethan Cole, get ready for the second. That one's up. That one is good. Makes it 13-13 with 12:34 to go here. Couple of substitutions coming in. Tyson Lofton, number 24 for WLA. Brooks with it on the right side, looking to drive, stops, posts it up, gets the floater to go. Ripon retakes the lead, 15-14. Barr looking to drive, nobody to dish it to. We're going to get a foul called away from the ball.
Timeout, official timeout.
And we got an official timeout here. Not sure what it was.
Is he giving a warning to the Ripon bench?
That's what it looked like he was
because,
pointing that way.
Yeah, he talked to the scores table. Pointed.
So, okay, the Ripon bench gets a warning. Ethan Cole inbounds it, gets it on top to Lofton. Back to Cole, back to Lofton. Lofton lowers that shoulder. That'll be the foul. That'll be Tyson Lofton's first, third on the Vikings. That was a hard fall.
Foul was on number 24, Tyson Lofton.
Cole Burdick inbounds it for the Tigers. Down in the corner to Carlson. Back to Burdick on top. The big guy puts it on the court and draws the foul.
Foul's being called. Foul's being called on number three.
That will be on Aiden Barr, his first. Fourth team foul on the Vikings. Carlson inbounded on the baseline for the Tigers. Little spin move gets it out to Riley Brooks as he's guarded by Cole. Brooks brings it back up on top, shoots it inside, gets knocked away, and Garrett Jennings comes up with it. Back over to Brooks out on the wing. Deep from downtown, off the iron, can't get it to go. And here come the Vikings. Cole took an extra step there, yeah. It's not the NBA.
Number two, Spencer Schultz on the court for Ripon.
Spencer Schultz will check back in for the Tigers as...
Coach didn't like the call.
Well, I mean, it was pretty obvious that extra step was there. Brooks brings it up, shoots it in the corner to Carlson. Carlson looking inside, nothing there. Kicks it out to Gilliffin. Back to Carlson from the corner, off the iron, can't get it to go. And rebound brought down by WLA. They're pushing it. Here comes Cole. A little behind the back move, gets it out the bar, back to Cole from way downtown, off the iron. And hard rebound brought down by the Tigers, and Schultz puts it up and off the underside of the basket there. And Cole drives the length of the court and puts that one in for two.
Both teams running big, big time. At Silver Creek Dentistry and Orthodontics, you can always trust us when it comes to your smile. Full-service dental care with the best technology available for your strong, beautiful, and healthy smile. That's Silver Creek Dentistry and Orthodontics.
That foul was picked up by Brandon Carlson. So Cole will go to the line shooting one. On its way, off the iron, can't get it to go, and Schneider brings that one down. 16-15, WLA with the lead. In and out in the corner from Carlson. And here comes Cole again, looking to drive. They kick that back outside. Moving around, Barr with a little stutter step, wasn't called. And they're gonna call Carlson on the arm. That'll be his third, so he'll probably sit the rest of the half with 10:26 to go.
Shooting is Aiden Barr for the Vikings.
Aiden Barr at the line. First one is up and good.
Jennings comes in for the Tigers. Lucas Wyatt comes in for the Vikings.
Fortify Bank is growing Wisconsin. One person, one business, one relationship at a time. Visit fortifybank.com to see how banking locally is a slam dunk for you in our community. Member FDIC. Barr with the second one on its way, and that is good also. WLA has a three-point lead, 18-15, with 10:20 to go here as Riley Brooks kicks it down into the corner to Schultz. Schultz looking to come around. Kicks it out to Jennings, who just checked back in. Over to Brooks. Brooks looking to drive that baseline. A nice job of cutting that off by WLA. And ran down by Garrett Jennings. Back out to Schneider. Brooks. Little sidestep from the free throw line. Rattles around, can't get it to go. And here comes Cole for WLA. Little shake and bake there. Puts it up and in, and no foul called underneath there.
Good body control by Cole, I'm impressed. He is always under control. He gets by his first defender, and then even with good rotation on the defense from the weak side by Ripon, he's still able to snake his body around and avoid the contact for the charge. Ripon went down hard on his banging his head, so I think it's getting the cobwebs out.
That was Schneider who went down. He did a nice job of just staying straight up and not drawing the foul there.
As a locally owned and operated business since 1987, Webster's Marketplace is proud to support high school sports and our Ripon Tigers. Webster's Marketplace, Highway 23 West in Ripon.
Gilfillan checking the ball in to Jennings for the Tigers as he crosses midcourt. Up on top looking, going now down to the right side, gets it inside to Brooks. Brooks gets triple teamed, puts it up, gets it to drop. Riley Brooks with another. Gives him 11.
Still trailing, Ripon.
Barr with a shake and bake there, kicks it back out to Cole. Deep three, that's good.
Basket's good by number four.
And what, foul away from the basket?
Yes.
And
fouls on number 23, Lucas Wagon for the Vikings.
So the foul was called after the ball was released by the shooter, so the basket counted, but the personal foul still goes against WLA.
Wynig picks up the foul. Brooks up on top on the left side. He's looking to go inside. Little give and go there. Tap out to Jennings. Gets it over to Schultz, who kicks it over to Riley Brooks for the three-pointer.
Good job by Brooks. Circles around the top as an outlet. Everything is sinking down on the ball down low. A kick out wide open for the shot.
Bar drives, puts it up. No, but there is Riley Brooks brings down that rebound. Pushing it up to Jennings, back to Brooks. He thought about the three, kicks it outside. Schultz from the corner, count it. Spencer Schultz's first basket of the game. And we're tied at 23 with 8.5 to go here in the first. And we get a timeout here by WLA.
Schultz shoots 38% from threes, leading the Ripon Tigers.
Drive your favorite teams to the games with Lamers Bus Line. Lamers is now hiring school bus drivers. Great pay, flexible schedules, complete driver training, bonuses up to $1,500. Apply in person at golamers.com/carriers.
Hillside Dental Associates in Ripon has been offering complete range of premium dental care for over 35 years, including preventative hygiene, cosmetic and restorative procedures, along with Invisalign and sedation dentistry. That's Hillside Dental and Associates.
To be a sponsor of your next Ripon High School basketball game, give Todd Sharp a call at 920-960-4569. So we're tied at 23 with 8:30 to go here in the first half.
What's impressive to me, and that Ripon I think we'll have to talk about at halftime in the locker room, it's so far for WLA, it's pretty much number three and four. It's the Bar Cole show. And those are the two guys they need to defensively do a better job on and make somebody else beat you.
And that's pretty much what it was over in Omro with them. And get a foul on the floor as Cole drives.
Ripon's having difficulty taking away the penetration dribble by Aiden Barr, the 5'10 junior. And when he does drop, he doesn't shoot it himself. He kicks it out typically to an open Ethan Cole, who can either shoot the pill from downtown or take his people off the dribble and finishes very nicely at the rim.
A little long on that one. Rebound brought down by Jennings. And Schultz pushes it up, back to Jennings. Over to Brooks from the left wing. Count that one for three. Riley Brooks heating it up.
That gives them a lead to break the tie, 26-23, Ripon with 8 minutes left in the first half.
Brooks has 17 here in the first half. Barr drives, stops, kicks it back outside. Shot comes up a little short, batted around, and kicked out quickly to Brooks, down to Schultz. You got to call a double dribble, yep.
Yep. Good idea. Both teams, I'd like to see the shuttle time on some of these individuals on both teams.
They're pretty quick, that's for sure. Barr bringing it up court, crosses the midcourt line, has Jennings guarding him, kicks it over. Kuski kicks it over to Cole. Back to Barr, back out to Cole. He'll go deep. Count that one. Ethan Cole from downtown. And a turnover there, lost the handle on it, was Gilfin. And Cole drives the lane all the way, can't get it to go, gets his own rebound, and brings it back outside. Vikings reset here. Barr looking to drive, kicks it to the corner to Cole. Off the iron, Brooks gets the rebound, and here come the Tigers. Brooks looking, stops, puts it down. And can't get the bunny to drop.
Ouch. Tied up here, 26 all.
Just under seven to go. Long three, real long three. Brooks brings down that rebound for the Tigers.
Great box out by Brooks.
Stops at the free throw line, puts it up and in for two. Griffin takes that lead, 28-26. Aiden Barr brings it up, crosses, looks, now drives, kicks it back outside to Cole. Little slide inside, no call. Barr with the three-pointer. And turn around, and WLA takes the one-point lead, 29-28. 6 minutes to go here in the first half. Brooks directing traffic from the left side.
Yeah, we see LA, WLA into it.
And we're going to get a mask warning.
And they could have done that a long time ago because I saw another Ripon player with it all the way down to his chin and nothing was said. I was kind of wondering about it myself.
Well, we saw a lot of that in the JV game too. And Alex Mansell checking in number four for the Tigers. And number three, Connor Diedrich.
Like I said, WLA has gone to an extended 3-2 zone for the first time.
Connor Diedrich kicks it down into the corner. Slides it over to Mansell. Down underneath to Jennings, cutting the baseline.
And that's where his zone is susceptible, and that's along the baseline. He got in behind him on the weak side, and he was an orphan. Great find.
30-29, Tigers on top. Kicks that one back outside to Kuski. Over to Cole. Cole with the deep three off the iron, can't get it to go. And the big bear cleans the glass.
Yeah, Gensler came down with it for WLA, but then it was stolen.
Schultz puts that up from the corner, can't get that to go. And here comes Cole for WLA, working against Jennings.
Yeah, good defense by Jennings.
Schultz turns around and gets beat by Barr, but Schneider there for that missed shot. He brings it up all the way. And we're going to get an over the back.
Yeah, I don't want Schneider trying to play point guard on top. I just don't. And
no.
And you're in a hotly contested game. He had the guard to his left. Just give it to the guard and go do your thing down low.
Follows on Lewitt. That's the sixth team foul for WLA.
Cole comes out for WLA, takes a seat.
Ball inside to Spencer Schultz, and he goes up, and it's a jump ball.
You got a foul call on the weak side ref and a jump ball on the other.
So they're going to talk it over here.
Well, we'll see who wins out.
Foul's got to overrule it, I would assume. As they're discussing here, and they're going to call the jump ball. Ball must have happened after the jump ball, but the ball will stay with the Tigers with 4:47 to go here. They lead by one, 30-29. Ball's into Schneider, looking, dumps it off, and unable to get that in is Schultz, but he does draw the foul.
Schultz is one of those Ripon players that has a lot of JV playing last year. And I can see the difference just in his playing.
A little more maturity.
From the beginning of the season to now. Plays with a lot more confidence.
With that first one as Riley Brooks will get ready to check in.
Ripon Area School District celebrates its students, staff, and parents for rising to the challenges of the school year. We are so proud of all of you and your continued efforts to keep each other safe and working with us to provide many opportunities for our students as possible during the unprecedented time. Thank you to our Ripon community for our continued support to the school district. Together, Ripon roars, go Tigers.
Well, with that situation, turn around and Schultz missed the free throw, got his own rebound, and then was called for traveling as he spun around. So
I knew I shouldn't have complimented him. My bad.
4:41 to go here, Tigers on top, 30-29. And Barr, as always, brings it up for WLA. Brings it up on the right side, looking to go to the left, feeds it down into the corner. Pusma puts it up, can't get it to go. And Pusma stays with it and steals the inbound pass, but that one comes up short. This time Schneider pulls it down.
Yeah, now they're going to catch it. Should be against 14, Gensler. Let's see who they call it on the reach in on the big fella for the Tigers.
That's who it is. That'll be the eighth team foul on WLA. So Schneider will go to the line, sorry.
The pattern along the sides on the blue uniforms reminds me of University of Kentucky Wildcats, the checkered pattern.
Schneider misses that one. And here comes Barr with it.
Boy, Bart's got great feet. Very light on his feet.
And we're going to get a foul there.
Yeah.
And a hold.
And that's his feet. That's him. He's able to get around. He can get by the hip of the defender and then creates that sense of urgency by the defense on Ripon.
Connor Diedrich will pick up the foul there.
That's the thing that stands out with me with this WLA. I'm quite surprised that they are shooting statistically during this season as bad as they have, but definitely they are very athletic.
I was fortunate to watch them against Omro, and I agree with you 100%. Rebound finally brought down by Mansell for the Tigers, and they get it over to Brooks. Brooks will bring it up across the midcourt line. Takes it, goes into the corner. Jennings will bring it around the top. Cross court.
Still playing the zone.
Brooks for three from the corner.
And that's what they'll tell you. That's how you beat a zone. You shoot over the top of it. Nice skip pass was what freed Brooks to get that look.
And Barr pulls up for the three-pointer. Can't get it to go. And
yeah,
Mansell with the rebound.
Barr with a nice step back. Just didn't fall for him.
Jennings from the corner for three. Had to wait for that confirmation from the official.
Back-to-back threes by Ripon now gives them that half-dozen point lead with 3:20 remaining in the first half.
Barr from the corner, he'll put up for three off the iron. And we're going to get a foul.
They're going to call this on Brooks because I thought he avoided contact. Yeah. Let's see.
Foul's been called on number 10.
That's who it will be.
Yeah, and I knew they were going to do that because... but I felt he did a great job of avoiding the contact.
Posma will go to line. First one is up, and that is good. Gives him 2 points.
Last 3 minutes of this game, refs have kind of let the game go in the transition. I think there's been a lot of more contact and no whistle. But they're doing it evenly. Let's see if they continue to let the rope out, or if they're going to reel them back in with the whistles.
And Posma connects on both of them, making it 36-32, Tigers with the lead. Brooks brings it up court. Up on the right side, looking, directing traffic, down into the corner. And we'll get a foul on Posma as he reaches over the back.
Little triangle offense. You go to the top, to the corner, corner to the same strong side block. And they collapsed on him, too much contact. We're going to see Cole Burdick at the line for the first time.
Shot is up, and that is good. Nice job there. Getting ready for second shot is Burdick. That one rolls around and drops down. Makes it 38-32, 3 minutes to go here in the first half. From the Tiger Den in Ripon.
Speedy Gonzalez, Barr with the ball.
Gets it over to Cole. Cole drives, kicks it back out to Barr. Barr. Little footwork there between the legs. Back up on top. Kuski drives in, can't get it to go.
Boy, great moves, and we're seeing they're not finishing. But a great up and under. Yep.
Long, deep for three for Brooks. No good.
And
Burdick and Mansell were fighting over the ball and knocked it out of bounds.
Actually, it was two WLA players were fighting with it. And then Burdick was behind him and was the recipient of the loose ball. And then Mansell stepped up. And then he put his boxing gloves on and lost it.
2:20 to go here in the first half. Barr brings it up, kicks it over to Cole. Little drive untested there was Kuski for his first 2 points of the game.
Oh, that hurts you.
That was too easy.
Yeah, that's what hurts you defensively.
And a long three by Schneider.
That's not a good shot by Schneider. And great job by Schultz out hustling Ginsler. His counterpart is going to get two free throws.
That'll be Ginsler's second. We all need a few good signs. Graphic Sign and Letter in Ripon creates eye-catching, compelling graphics for your business banner and your events.
24 affiliate comes back on the court for Ripon.
Visit Graphic Sign in Ripon. J. So the first one made by Schultz. Second one on its way, but it rolls around, and that's going to be knocked out of bounds. That should be Tiger ball as it went off of number four there. So Brooks will inbound it for the Tigers.
Nursing a five-point lead, the host team Tigers are.
Tried to force it inside. He had Schultz on the wing, and the turnover there. Cole up, misses the bunny.
That's the last guy in the gym, along with Brooks, you expect to miss that breakaway.
Yeah. Schneider for three, gets one to drop down. A little hard rim shattering there, but gets the three to drop. Makes it 42-34. Minute and a half to go here in the first half. WLA feeds it inside, gets it to go up and drop, and that's Ginsler with the basket. And we'll have a 30-second timeout.
Ripon takes that timeout. At Silver Creek Dentistry and Orthodontics, you can always trust us when it comes to your smile. Full-service dental care with the best technology available for your strong, beautiful, and healthy smile. That's Silver Creek Dentistry and Orthodontics.
Fortify Bank is growing Wisconsin. One person, one business, one relationship at a time. Visit fortifiedbank.com to see how banking locally is a slam dunk for you in our community. Member FDIC.
Rebound with a positive message. Start a successful marketing plan on hometown radio with a call to Todd Sharp at 920-960-4569. That's hometown radio.
1:27 to go here in the first half. Tigers will inbound the ball. They lead 42-36 over WLA. Garrett Jennings will bring it up. Working down that right side. Gets it into Schneider. Schneider looking, picked up his dribble, and there's Riley Brooks. Who else better to give it to? Schneider will try another three. Just got one in, got the second one to go.
Wow, that was a facial, and Tyler Kusky's going, wait a minute.
Yeah, how did that
Big
happen?
Guy steps it out with back-to-back threes.
What a surprise. Barr will bring it up over mid-court line with under a minute to go here. They get it to Cole up on top. He sees a little crack in the lane and drives up and puts it in.
Boy, does Cole do a great job of using his body to shield off Schneider for the Tigers.
A lot of hang time there. There's a travel by Schultz as he does that little stutter step.
For the most part, Ripon Howard, has done a good job against that zone by the Vikings.
They've moved the ball around very well.
That's right, you want to get that zone to shift.
Barr brings it up, kicks it off to the side. Little feed inside to Kusky for the easy basket there. Under 30 seconds to go here. Brooks out on the wing, gets it over to Jennings. Down to Schultz. Schultz feeds it down inside to Gilfin. Back out to Jennings, down in the corner. Schultz looking, kicks it back out on top to Brooks. That's who they'd expect to take the shot. Schultz tries to feed it, can't do it, and comes up short.
Boy, everything was right except the shot.
Yeah. Last second shot put up, and that's no good. And we will come to the end of the thrilling first half. With the Tigers leading 45-40. We'll be back with the second half and highlights in a few moments on Ripon Tigers Sports Network. Welcome back to the Ripon High School Gymnasium, where it's halftime as your Tigers lead the Winnebago Lutheran Vikings 45-40. Individual scoring for the Vikings. They're led by Ethan Cole with 15, Aiden Barr with 13, and Tyler Kruske with 4, Noah Ginsler with 5, and Zachary Postma with 3. The Vikings have 13 rebounds and 3 turnovers. For the Tigers, they're being led by the super sophomore, Riley Brooks, with 22, followed by Garrett Jennings with 9, Grant Schneider with 8, and Spencer Schultz with 4, and Cole Burdick with 2. Tigers have 17 rebounds and 6 turnovers, so hopefully they can cut that mark down a little bit. Marty, your thoughts on the first half, and what do the Tigers need to do to save this victory in the second half?
Talked about it in the first half. I think that for a team that's winless, the Vikings have shown a lot of moxie out here in the first, 18 minutes these days of play. And it's been the Ethan Cole, Aiden Barr show primarily. Aiden Barr, who averages 11 on the season, already has surpassed that with 13 at the half. So he's off to a great start statistically. Ethan Cole has shown why he averages 25 a game. I think that the Ripon defense has been exposed in the first half primarily with the ball penetration by Barr, the ability to break down the Ripon defense, get the ball into the middle. And when the ball is in the middle, that's bad news for the defense. And then he can kick it out or try to get it to his buddy Cole, his wingman. So Ripon, I think, did a better job towards the latter stages of the first half of the offense by those two dynamic duos. But that's the key. You have to try to do what you can against those two guys defensively if you're Ripon. Both teams like to get up and run, so from an entertainment value, we've had a great time to watch that. I think Ripon, I don't do much. I don't really change a lot. I'm hoping that Schneider doesn't just stay on the outside now after making his back-to-back threes, because you have to have some inside presence. But I think both teams, they do a lot of things similar, to be honest with you. Not just the transition, the up and down part of the offense, Howard. But I see a lot of the half-court stuff is the same, where they like to penetrate and kick it to the open man. So, like I said, I'm kind of surprised after seeing the first half of the Vikings that they haven't been able to come up with a win, unless they've just been playing against teams with outstanding records.
Well, like I said, I got a chance to call the game that Amro. They played against Amro, and that went overtime. And turn around, and most of their games, like you said, have been averaging 9-point loss. So a couple shots here, a couple rebounds there, and it's a totally different record for them.
Right, and in such a up-tempo game like this, if someone's down by 8 points, it doesn't mean a lot, because a three-pointer, a foul, a missed shot, and a quick outlet pass, next thing you know, you're only down by one possession. So I'm just going to look for more of the same. I think the thing that stands out in my mind the most, Ripon and the half-court defense has to do a little bit better job, especially with the rotation and the help, and then because of the athleticism of Barr to break him down with his dribble. And then I think for the most part, how many points does Cole have for
Winnebago? He has 15, Barr has 13.
Yeah, so they're both on pace of what they, 15 by Cole is pretty impressive.
Well, if you can turn around and shut those two somewhat down make the rest of the team beat you.
Right, right.
It's a totally different ballgame there.
They're not going to shut them down, no way. But if they can make them work a little harder for their points. And, I'm not sure if anybody's in foul trouble for Ripon.
The only one in foul trouble is Brandon Carlson. If you remember, at the 10-minute mark, he had to sit down with 3.
Yeah.
Otherwise, everybody else has 1 except for Agamite, who has 2. So Ripon in good situation foul-wise.
Yeah, his third foul, Carlson, was on that reach-in, on that penetration drive that I was talking, that they've been so good at breaking down the Ripon defense. So that'll be interesting to see if he can get back out there. He was really the defensive igniter in that Berlin game that got things going for the host team Tigers.
Well, he has great hustle, and that's what I like to see on the young man, is just going at it. So we're getting ready here to start the second half very shortly. With that, drive your favorite teams to the game with Lamer's Bus Line. Lammers is now hiring school bus drivers. Great pay, flexible schedules, complete driver training, and bonuses up to $1,500. Apply in person at golammers.com/carriers. So WLA will have the ball to start the second half here. And of course, Barr will bring it up. Crosses midcourt, has Jennings on him. Moving it around, get it down inside to Cole. Kicks it back up on top. They're moving the ball around pretty well. Back to Cole. Into the corner, Cuskey with it. Looking for somebody, gets it out the Barr. They rotate it around to Cuskey. Back to Cole. Down inside to Ginsler. Puts that one up, can't get it to go. And here come the Tigers. Brooks with it, tries feeding it underneath. Does get it to Schultz. Nice pass to Jennings, steps inside the arc, puts it in for two.
Great find by Schultz to Jennings, good job.
47-40, just underway here in the second half.
I thought WLA did a great job on their first offensive possession, and then the kid got impatient and forced a bad shot.
Ginsler with the ball, kicks it around. Barr loses the handle, gets it back. He'll drive in, kicks it out to Cole. Long three, that's good.
Wow.
For Ethan Cole.
Almost turned it over and ended up being a three for Cole.
Schultz looking that he was going to get hammered and laid it up a little soft there.
Evidently the open layups tonight come at a premium for both teams.
And a little turnover there by WLA. The big guy, Schneider, brings it up court. Little stutter step underneath the Eggmite. And puts it in.
Wow.
That's his first two of the night.
Yeah, remember, he sat almost the entire first half picking up two quick fouls. I think he's one of those guys defensively, Howard, that will help the Tigers immeasurably.
I like his rebounding, that's for
well,
sure.
Well, it's everything. I mean, you look at all the stats.
Cole with a long three. Gives him six in the first half here, 21 on the game. And just like that, it's a three-point game, 49-46. Brooks can't get it to go, has two shots at
it. Wow, did a great job of getting his own board, couldn't finish.
And that one's put up and down, no good. Brought down by the Tigers. Eggemite kicks it out to Brooks. Falling away, puts it up, he'll draw the foul. No, they're going to call a charge on him.
That's an interesting call.
That it is.
To me, it's just a no, there's no whistle there. Ref saw it differently.
Just let it play out.
That'll be his second on Brooks.
First on the Tigers here in the second half.
Ripping by three.
Anticipation there on the pass by Brooks. Puts it down, slams it down. Gets those two back quickly. Cuskey looking to drive all the way in. And
they're going to call a foul on Brooks.
Yeah.
Watch this.
That's who it will be. That'll be his third.
Totally unintentional. They tied up feet.
Yeah.
So a quick two on Brooks. And he's a guy you can't have.
Can't lose, not when you have Barr
trouble.
And Cole. And speaking of Cole, for three, that one's off. And Jennings brings down that rebound. Jennings up on top, has it knocked away. Gets it up to Brooks on the right side here. Riley setting everybody. Here comes Schneider to the top. Gets the screen there.
You know what he's thinking.
Yeah. Gets it off to Jennings. Jennings a little fake there. Takes it into the lane, steps back, puts it up, count it.
Smooth shot by Jennings.
Nice little move there.
The senior six-footer.
53-46. Going to get an official timeout. That'll be mask violation on Brooks. He's got to come out. Burdick will check in for him.
Well, Burdick better keep his on because he was the one that I saw earlier in the first half with his all the way down to the chin. So this is key part. Remember this now. Ripon is up by seven when Brooks leaves.
Feet inside to Cole. Stops, kicks it back outside. taking the lane, throws it up, can't get that to drop is Postma.
Good.
And Schneider brings it down.
Yeah, good one and done by the Tigers.
Schneider from on top for three, count it.
He's made his last three. A monster three-point shooter has just been developed.
Created,
here.
Yeah, exactly. Kuski with the ball on top, gets it over to Cole. Into the corner, they're going to call a hand check foul.
No, it wasn't. It was a reach for the ball. But just what a silly reach.
Schultz will pick up the foul.
What a silly reach. You get beat off the dribble, and you just reached around. And you have to adapt to what's being called.
So Brooks will check back in.
And that's why Carlson got in trouble for reaching.
Cole with it up on top, working the right side. Gets it to Postma, back inside, working it around. Here comes Cole, driving the lane.
Oh.
And the shot put up and in by Ginsler.
Ripon, that's an example of Ripon overextending defensively on the ball and then being exposed.
Burdick with a nice little turnaround shot there.
Yeah, that was. And what made it a nice shot was no dribble. He squared, yeah. Didn't take the rhythm dribble and give the defense a chance to collapse on him.
58-48, Tigers on top. Cole with the drive. They're going to call a travel. Yep. Yeah. A little too much spinning and the feet were dragging there.
Coach didn't like that call either, but he's got to protect his guy. And that's what he's been doing on both of those travel calls, one in the first half and now this one for Winnebago.
Jennings with the ball, bringing it up across midcourt. Gets it over to Schneider. He thought about the three. Down into Brooks. Brooks gets double teamed. And it'll go out of bounds off of WLA.
Ripon got a break there on a very, very high risk pass on a cutter. And it went off the foot of the defender for WLA. Ripon inbounds under their basket.
Burdick gets it in to Riley. Brooks puts up the two, count that one, as he is just inside the line.
And Brooks has really been on fire tonight, both from deep and from around the basket.
Well, he had 22 in the first half. Barr, nice bounce pass. And they're going to call that one on Schneider as he was behind.
It's so tempting. He lifts that ball. You're the big guy behind him to reach in into that cookie jar and grab that. But they've been very consistent on that call. You play defense reaching tonight, even if you don't foul them, they're going to call it. If it looks like a foul, it is a foul.
First one's up and short.
13, Postma comes in along with number three. That's Dietrich and number 25.
Wingand misses that first one. Tigers have four fouls already here in the second half, and none for WLA.
Yeah, so with Burdick and Egemite leaving for Ripon, they got a little smaller with Carlson coming in along with Dietrich for the Tigers.
So the second shot on its way. That's a little hard, bounces around, doesn't go down. Schneider pulls the rebound down. Gets it off to Riley Brooks. Here come the Tigers. They lead 60-48.
I think that's their biggest lead of the game.
Yes, it is. Carlson with the ball on top over to Schneider. Schneider gets the pick from Brooks. Brooks gets the ball now. He wants the pick. He says, return the favor. Back to Schneider. Schneider going in hard. Puts up the floater for the big guy.
Boy, he's got nice hands for a big guy.
Gives him 13 on the night.
Yeah, I'm going to call him the Bear.
It fits him. From the corner, gets that one to drop. Does Weinig for his first points of the game.
Going to get a full timeout called by the visitors from WLA.
Tigers.
Drive the roads and the lane with confidence all season long. Get ready for your next road trip adventure with Goodyear Tires from Cliffs Tire and Battery, West Fond du Lac Street in Ripon. Cliffs Tire and Battery.
We all need a few good signs. Graphic sign and lettering in Ripon creates eye-catching, compelling graphics for your business. Banners for your events, vehicle and boat lettering too. Capture attention with style and taste. Increasing your visibility since 1985. That's Graphic Sign in Ripon.
Hey, Hillside Dental Associates in Ripon has been offering a complete range of premium dental care for over 35 years, including preventative hygiene, cosmetic, and restorative procedures, along with Invisalign and sedation dentistry. That's Hillside Dental Associates.
Supported by Bank Growing Wisconsin. One person, one business, one relationship at a time. Visit fortifiedbank.com to see how banking locally is a slam dunk for you and our community. Member FDIC. 12-11 to go here in the ball game. Tigers leading 62-50, as Marty said, their biggest lead of the game. And Grant Schneider will inbound for the Tigers. Garrett Jennings back in here. And here we go as Jennings brings it up.
Well, let me tell you this. The two guys that came in, you know, with Carlson and Diedrich, those two guys are pesky defenders.
Schneider tries going for the three-pointer. Can't get that one to drop. Barr hurries up the court. Can't get it to go. Taps it over to Cole, who floats the lane. He comes up short. Rebound saved, but tossed to Barr. Cole drives the lane. Can't get that one to go. My goodness.
Yep.
Them bunnies are killing both teams. Jennings thought about it. Kicks it off to Brooks. That one doesn't go, and yeah, you got to call that one on Jennings.
Yeah, he wasn't going to, and then he did. In that, like you said, got out hustled to the ball. First man to the ball wins.
That's the fifth team foul on the Tigers.
Possession's 9/10 of the law.
That goes with space too.
And that was that. Well, yeah, exactly.
So 11:30 to go. 62-50. Barr bringing it up court as he has all night for the Vikings. Works down that right side, working against Jennings. Kicks it back on top to Cole. That one's no good as Schneider cleans the glass.
And the dynamic duo is struggling here in the second half.
Brooks looking, gets it over to Carlson. Spreads it around, back over to Jennings. To Brooks, feeds it inside.
One-on-one if he wants it.
Blues there, Diedrich takes the step. No basket.
That would not have been called in noon ball. I'll tell you that right now.
There you get, what, about 2.5 extra steps?
And a guy like Diedrich, you don't get that open look that often.
No.
And it's too bad. That's just comfort level with the ball on floor time.
Connor very disappointed there. Kuski drives in the lane, puts it up, gets that one to go.
That's that dribble penetration that really kind of hurt Ripon in the first half.
Brooks will bring it up right side, goes to the free throw line, puts it up, gets it to drop for Riley Brooks.
Wow.
Gives him 28 on the night. 64-52.
Yeah.
10.5 to go.
Yeah, we're not even halfway through the second half, so Brooks is on pace to maybe beat his season high.
And Diedrich with that rebound gets it over to Riley Brooks. Riley brings it up. Ooh, slip there.
Yeah, you got to be careful. That's how you do a double sprained ankle, too.
Don't know if it was a little wet there or if he just kind of slid.
Yeah.
Schneider will turn around and have a seat here as Agamite checks in. Number 22, Connor Lewick, checks in for WLA. And Barr bringing it up as he gets the ball from Kuski. Kuski cuts the lane. Barr was looking to toss it. Nobody there. Gets it to Cole. Swings it around. Kuski drives in. Kicks it back out on top. It's to Cole.
Good movement.
Barr will drive that lane. And they're going to call a charge.
Boy, that's a tough call. But what a great effort by number four for the Tigers.
Mansell.
What a great job.
Nice job.
Good feet. He maintained his chest. Stayed square up on him. If he would have turned either way, it would have been the call would have been a block.
Garrett Jennings bringing the ball up, works down the right side, gets it to Brooks. Oh, Brooks had an open look for the three, couldn't get it to go. Agamite can't get that one to go.
Nice play.
Transition here by Barr, working it down. Oh, a nice no-look pass from Barr. Down inside to Kuski. Kuski, soft little left hand and gets it to go.
It's been a rough one for Agamite tonight. He just missed on a great two-man roll, pick and roll there. Missed on the other end and comes back and picked up his third foul?
His third foul, yep.
Third personal foul for Agamite.
Webster's Express is a convenient way to get the grocery items you need without leaving your car or even your house. Order online at webstersmarketplace.com for contactless pickup or full service delivery. That's webstersmarketplace.com.
Mansell with the ball on top for the Tigers, gets underneath the Eggmite. He goes in, gets this one to go up and drop. Good use of the body there, gives him four on the night. Back 66-55, Tigers with the lead, coming up on the 9-minute mark. Bar over to Kusky. Cole works it on the right side, comes down in. Feed down inside, little strong there as Lofton goes up with it, can't get it to go. But
3-on-2.
Riley Brooks pulls up from the free throw line, gets that one to drop.
Such body control when he pulls up and transition on those mid-range jump shots.
Yeah, it's stop and then just straight up. Kusky with the drive, can't get it to go. Brooks had it. Missed it there. Goes inside, does Kusky, and he draws the foul.
Boy, it's going to be a tough one if it's on Eggemite or Brooks.
Mansell will pick it up.
Way to take one for the team.
Yeah, exactly. Tyler Kusky goes to the line. Puts the first one up and in.
Ripon Area School District celebrates its students, staff, and parents for rising to the challenges of the school year. We are so proud of all of you and your continued efforts to keep each other safe and working with us to provide as many opportunities to our students as possible during this unprecedented time. Thank you to our Ripon community for their continued support of your school district. Together, Ripon roars, go Tigers.
Schultz and Snyder checks back in for the Tigers. Second one by Kusky is up and good. Makes it 68-57. 8.5 to go here. Brooks brings it up down into the corner. Carlson over to Snyder. Drives that lane.
Going to call that reach.
Yep.
If you're a smart player, you figure it out and you talk about that over with your teammates. Hey, what are the refs calling here? Man, you don't take your feet with you and you reach, even if it's all ball. It's been a whistle all night.
Yeah. Barr picks up his third foul for the Vikings.
Oh. Foot was out of bounds.
Yeah, I was going to say, got a break on that one. Snyder for three. Off the iron, can't get it to go. Schultz, nice job of getting that rebound. Up on top to Brooks. Brooks with a little spin move, and they're going to call the travel.
Yeah, and the reason why he traveled because of the contact with the defender.
Yeah, it was a little tough down there for Brooks. 8 minutes to go in the ball game. 68-57, Tigers with that lead.
And it's been a hard battle all the way.
So Barr brings the ball up court. He's got three fouls. Over to Kusky.
Wow, what a hard V cut by Cole, but he stumbled.
Ginsler gets it back to Kusky, who drives that baseline, throws it up with a nice little reversal there.
Well done, great body control.
68-59. Mansell will draw the foul, and that should be on Ginsler.
Good job by Mansell, not backing out when the defender, but continuing with the shot and creating contact and getting rewarded with two free throws.
Chance to get some points on the night for Alex Mansell. First one's on its way and drops.
William Simmons in for the first time. He played the JV game. Ripon hung on to win by one. They led by seven at the half and won by one.
Mansell connects on both of them. Makes it 70-59. Yeah, that was a good game, 60-59. Tigers hung on to that JV game. And we're going to get a timeout here by the Vikings. It'll be a full timeout. We'll take it with them. We'll send it back out to Radio Road. We'll be back in 1 minute on Ripon Tiger Sports Network. Welcome back to Ripon High School Gymnasium. Tigers leading the Vikings 70-59, 7:29 to go here. It's been a great game. First half was the for WLA was the Bar and Cole show, and they've kind of cooled down just a little bit here in the second half.
Yeah, give a little credit to the Ripon defense. I think tightening it up, doing a better job, I think, of protecting the lane.
Bar with the ball, moves it around to Ginsel. Down to Kusky. He likes going down that right side of the lane. Can't get it back outside the Bar. That's going to come up short. And the rebound pulled down by Schneider. And the Tigers will slow things down a little bit here as the clock is on their side. Brooks brings it up the left side. Gets it to Carlson. Carlson looking to pass. Gets it over to Schultz. Brooks wanted it inside. Nothing there. Back over to Carlson. Good rotation. Cross-court pass to Brooks. Look at, oh, Carlson was open underneath. Brooks didn't see him. Gets the screen from Schneider for three. Brooks can't get that to go, and WLA brings it down. Bar with a little stutter step, not called. Throws it up, gets it to drop in.
Use the glass, very nice.
His first 2 points of the second half.
Yeah, he had 11. He already beat his average.
Yeah, he had 13 in the first half. But nice job, as you said earlier, by the Tigers to shut him down with him just scoring his first basket. And nice. Cole with the steal there.
Yeah, nice theft.
Now he gets up, drives in with a little backdoor shot, and Cole with eight here in the second half. Brooks puts it up, can't get it to roll. Ginsel with the rebound for the Vikings. And stepped on the line, did Kusky.
Yeah, did what he could. NCAA football, that would have been good with one foot in, but not in pro football.
Yeah, definitely a long court pass there, unable to control that one.
Yeah, so the Vikings, a short little run there to get it within seven.
Schultz checking the official on the count to slow this down a little bit. Can't get too lackadaisy, though. Riley Brooks drives that baseline. He'll pick up the foul.
Yeah, it was a blow by, I think, just had a little frustration there. Kusky just grabbed him. Made it easy for the official.
That'll be his second. Fourth team for the Vikings. Alley-oop into Schneider. Nice pass in there, and Grant Schneider puts it in for two.
We've seen him do that a few times this year.
Great
execution.
Gives him 15 on the night.
Yeah, three of those are on three-pointers.
Big guy goes up, gets it to drop there.
Yeah, he does a nice job, gives him inside presence.
Drove that baseline very nice. 72-65, Tigers on top, 5 minutes to go. Riley Brooks with a little shake and bake, tries getting it inside to Schneider. Jennings pulls it down. Good hustle there. And a timeout being called by Ripon there. As 4:52 left here in the ballgame. Tigers leading the Vikings 72-65. Drive with confidence all season long. Get ready for your next road trip adventure with Goodyear Tires from Cliff's Tire and Battery, West Fond du Lac Street, Ripon.
Webster's Marketplace is proud to sponsor high school sports. Visit us today for fresh produce, meat cut in-store, and deli and bakery that are always cooking up meals, side dishes, and the sweet treats for all of you to enjoy. Webster's Marketplace, Highway 23 West in Ripon.
It's a slam dunk. Dunk. Radio advertising gets heard. Call Hometown Broadcasting at 920-960-4569 and ask for Todd Sharp.
Oh, yeah? Way. We all need a few good signs, Howard. Graphic sign and letter, Ripon creates eye-catching, compelling graphics for your business banners, for your events, vehicle and boat lettering to capture attention with style and taste. Increasing your visibility since 1985, that's Graphic Sign.
Back with 4:52 to go here in the ballgame. Tigers will side it on. They lead 72-65. Jennings with the ball, gets it into Carlson up on top, over to Brooks on the left wing. Rooks looking to set up Schneider. There's the alley-oop in. Schneider gets it. Covered by Simmons. Simmons did a nice job of cutting him off there. Schultz with a little drive in. Can't get it to go, but will draw the foul.
Coming off that timeout by Coach Brooks and the Ripon Tigers. Nice job. What they did was the offensive half-court spacing. They had great spacing. Moved the ball crisp. And Schneider with a great find.
So Cole will pick up his first foul. Schultz goes to the line and puts the first one in. Gives him
15.
Simmons down there. Second one is up and good.
But Simmons did a good job of holding his own, and Schneider, instead of forcing a bad shot, found an open teammate. Good things happen when you move without the ball.
A little bit of patience needed there. A little fake and drive on the baseline, and that is up and in there for Posma. His first 2 points of the second half.
And that his counterpart for Ripon, I would say, is probably Agamite. Mm. Those are the same two kind of players.
Brooks with the ball over on the left wing. Being guarded by Kuski. Gets it over to Jennings. Jennings taking his time. Down to Schultz. Nothing there. Schultz brings it around to Schneider. Schneider looking to drive. Throws it up. Can't get it to go. And here comes the Vikings. Cole with the drive, can't get that bunny to go. And the Tigers bring down the rebound as Brooks chases that one down.
Cole has to be frustrated after that big offensive effort in the first half. Has had to really work and has missed a lot of shots, high percentage shots, actually.
Yeah, those little bunnies will come back to kill.
Yeah, so much for being a bunny. It just looks like it to you and me.
Carlson with the ball, directing traffic over on the left wing, gets it back out on top. Trying to bring that defense out a little bit as he gets it over to Brooks.
Yeah.
Brooks a little stutter step there. Down into the corner. Jennings normally would pop that, but using up the clock here a little bit as it goes to Schneider up on top.
Their spacing is better. They're being much more deliberate and much more patient coming off of that timeout.
Jennings just up there. Gets the five count. Down to Brooks. He fakes it. Back on top. That'll go out of bounds as it's knocked out of bounds by Ethan Cole.
Below 3 minutes now, 74-67, the Tigers. But WLA refuses to go away. Just when Ripon gets double digits up on him, they come back on him and get it down to single digits. So WLA still very much in this game.
Agamite checks in for the Tigers as Carlson will have a break. Jennings up on top. He's guarded by Cole. Schultz. Down into Agamite, who just checked in. He's got to bring that out of that corner.
I don't know what's going on with the guys down there, but boy, they're footing.
Yeah.
You don't wonder if it's just sweat or if they're just
fatigued and dropping.
I don't know. But we've seen a number of Ripon players do that tonight.
I was more worried about that knee the way he went down. It didn't look good. Barr brings it across midcourt line and get a timeout here, 32nd, with the Tigers leading 74-67, 2:32 to go. Lamers Bus Line, drive your favorite teams to the games. Lamers is now hiring school bus drivers. Great pay, flexible schedule, complete driver training, and bonuses up to $1,500. Apply in person or go to lamers.com/carriers.
At Silver Creek Dentistry and Orthodontics, you can always trust us when it comes to your smile. Full service dental care with the best technology available for your strong, beautiful, and healthy smile. That's Silver Creek Dentistry and Orthodontics.
2:32 to go here in the ballgame. Tigers with the lead, 74-67. In foul trouble for the Tigers, with three is Brandon Carlson, Agamite, and Brooks. Got to keep an eye on those. Kuski with the ball, kicks that inside to Cole.
Oh, what
nice job by Agamite.
Oh, he does everything. You love him for rebounding, but he just does it all. You know, rebounding, defense. What a great, it's one thing to block a guy. It's another thing to block it and get the ball.
Right.
You just don't see that very often at any level of basketball.
And a frustration foul there by Ethan Cole as he picks up his second.
That's the other point. Look who he did it against.
So Schneider inbounds it to Schultz.
Yeah, full court pressure, a 1-2-2, but they pull it off quickly.
Brooks will bring it across midcourt, drive that lane, dump it under to Agmite, and they're going to call the charge.
Brooks. Yeah, Brooks.
On Brooks.
Yeah, he got rid of the ball cleanly, but when he came down,
he was drifting.
Yeah, and he took it for the team, 13.
That's his fourth foul on Brooks.
Yeah, I thought he was going to have to come out, but he popped up to his feet. That was
Posma?
Posma. Another nice player. Role player.
Yep.
I hate the term blue collar, but that's what he is.
That's what it is, yeah, exactly. Kuski with the ball, kicks it to Cole in the corner. He'll drive in. Barr a little stutter step. He'll drive the lane. Can't get it to go, but a nice job there by Posma. Turning around and getting that rebound.
Should get called for 3 seconds, but he won't.
And Barr will finish that off with 2 points.
Yeah, and the Barr-Cole show just kind of cooled off here in the second half. Give Ripon defense some credit.
Yeah, that's one of the things we said they had to do, is step it up a little bit. Schneider from the free throw line kicks it back outside. Smart move there. As the clock is your friend right now, as we're at a minute and a half to go here.
Yeah, play like you have the lead, and that's what Ripon's doing right now.
Schultz gets it down into the corner to Schneider. He's guarded by Simmons, and Simmons will foul.
Whistle the foul called against the Vikings. Foul's going to be called number 15. That's William Simmons.
Yep.
And that should be the seventh. So we'll go to the line shooting the one and one will be Grant Schneider. He's got 15 so far on the night.
Yeah, the Big Bear has good hands, good soft hands, been saying it all season. And what better thing attribute to have than free throw shooting is soft hands.
Puts that first one in.
Yeah. Very nicely.
He's had a good game. Solid rebounds.
He's having a good season, no doubt. Second leading scorer on the ball club.
Connects on both of them. Pure as can be. 76-69. Tigers with that lead. Barr will bring it across for WLA. Kicks it out to Kuski. He likes to go in that lane to that left side with that little turn jumper there. And he gets that one to drop and makes it a 5-point difference. 76-71. Tigers up here. And coming up next for the Tigers, Marty.
Yeah, this Friday. They're going to jump back in their first conference game since the 18th of December when they beat their friends from Berlin. And that's going to go on the road down to Kettle Moraine Lutheran, the team that is in third place. Ripon's nursing a second place position in the East Central Conference, just one game out of first behind those Panthers of Plymouth. So that'll be Friday, a good test for the Tigers. Interesting how both road games against the top two competitors are road games.
Yeah.
So they're going to get both of those teams, both Plymouth as well as Kettle Moraine Lutheran at home later this season.
Yep. Well, you want to win the conference, beat those top teams on the road, and then secure it at home.
Right.
So
they didn't do it against the Panthers in their first conference game of the year.
Got to get it in just about 5 seconds, and that's what they're going to call.
Give great job by the Vikings on denying an outlet pass by the inbounder Schneider for the Tigers. Good stick-to-itiveness by that defensive pesky bunch from WLA.
Tigers need to return the favor here if possible. They get it in quick to Barr, over to Kuski.
Well, you know who they want to get the ball to if they can.
Cole or Barr, or Kuski gets that little move here. Here goes Barr.
Good defense.
Kicks it back out, yep.
Good defense by Schultz, trying to do what he can.
Cole turns around and drives it up there, can't get it to go as Brooks brings down the rebound.
Spencer Schultz, good job. You got an injured player. They're not taking a timeout.
Yeah,
now they're going to call the block on WLA.
That's Cole down on the floor for WLA.
Yeah, it is. But what a nice job by Spencer Schultz, frustrating Cole into taking a difficult pass or a shot attacking the rim. And it looks like that Riley Brooks is a little shaken up as well.
I think a lot of these guys, it's fatigue setting in as they've turned around and really hustled a lot here.
Yeah, they have.
76-71, Tigers on top here. It was 45-40 at the half. So the Tigers have stretched it out a little bit. They had, I think it was a 12-point lead at one time, and then
it
dropped off.
Yeah, it was 62-50. Hillside Dental Associates in Ripon has been offering a complete range of premium dental care for over 35 years, including preventative hygiene, cosmetic and restorative procedures, along with Invisalign and sedation dentistry. That's Hillside Dental Associates in Ripon.
Well, Ethan Cole, who just went down for WLA, he's got 23 points on the night. Just too shy of his average, I believe.
Yeah.
Jennings will go to the line.
And Aiden Barr averages 11 per game, and I had written down 11.
He had 13 at the half.
Yeah, you changed your mind on me.
And he's got 17.
You sold me down the river when you said that, and I know I wrote down 11. Put it this way, folks. He's well above his season average.
Right, exactly.
He's a beast, and he's got the ball right now.
Turn around, and Cole, a little off balance there, but here's that nice movement. Agamite's going to be nailed with a foul there. That'll be his fourth. And they'll say Kuski was in the act of shooting.
What Kuski does well, he uses his back side to keep the defender at bay, creates the contact. First free throw is good. Down by six, 38 seconds left in the game. Ripping up by a half dozen.
Kuski with the second one on the way. That's good, gives him 17 on the night. Schneider looking to get it in.
Yep. Tough defense.
We're going to get a foul away from the ball.
I call that. That was just denial. That's just what we call belly button to belly button defense. And someone got called for the hold.
Fouls on number 34, Kuski forward.
Well, the young man that just made the free throws on the three-point play.
So that'll be his fourth. And put Riley Brooks on the line.
Now, not an easy game to officiate tonight. In that first half in particular, he had a lot of transition. A lot of pent-up energy, huh?
I would say after not playing since mid-December for the Tigers.
A couple times these guys were going full court and their feet weren't even touching the floor.
Brooks makes the first one, second one on its way. That is good also. Tigers stretch that lead out to 70-73. And Barr pushes it down quick. Up for three, can't get that one to go, was Posma. And Grant
Schneider pulls that down. Yeah, it was a delay call, but Schneider was fouled. Now he'll go to the line.
14.
So
that.
So the Ripon Area School District celebrates its students, staff, and parents for rising to the challenges of the school year. We are so proud of all of you and your continued efforts to keep each other safe and working with us to provide as many opportunities for our students as possible during this unprecedented time. Thank you to our Ripon community for your continued support of school district. Together, Ripon roars. Go Tigers.
And Schneider puts both of them in there. Makes it 82-73. We're coming up on 20 seconds left. Barr with it, looking for somewhere to go with it. Goes to Kuski. Puts up the long three. Can't get that one to go.
Crossover.
Cole kicks it back out again to Barr. Barr puts it up, no good. Long rebound. And Jennings pulls that one down finally and gets grabbed with 7.1 seconds to go.
Boy, I don't know if the refs just got tired, but there was a lot going on there.
And no whistles. Aiden Barr will pick up his fourth as Jennings will go to the line. Can't get that one to crawl in as it goes off to the left side. Good performance by the Tigers tonight after that long layup.
Yeah.
And Jennings misses that one also.
I think their defense in the second half did a better job of showing up.
From over in Fond du Lac, Barr puts up that shot, can't get it to go. And the Tigers will get the victory, 82-73. We'll turn around and take a two-minute break and be back with the final stats and wrap this one up from the Ripon High School gym. Back in 2 minutes. Welcome back to the Ripon High School Gymnasium, where the Tigers have just defeated the Vikings from WLA 82-73 in a great ball game. Individual scoring for the Vikings. Leading the way was Ethan Cole with 23, Aiden Barr with 17, and Tyler Kuski with 17. Zachary Pulsma with 5, Noah Geisler with 7, and then Williams and Weingard each chipping in with 2. The Vikings had 22 rebounds and 7 turnovers. For the Tigers, they were led by Riley Brooks with 32. Garrett Jennings and Grant Schneider each chipping in 17. Spencer Schultz with 6 points. And Agamite and Mansell with 2. Tigers had 31 rebounds and 11 turnovers. So they got to work on that turnover ratio there, Marty.
Actually, I'll tell you what. I'm amazed that seven turnovers by the visitors and only 11. I'll tell you what, if you're around that 10 area and single digits, you're good, particularly when you put it in the perspective of the transition type of game that we witnessed tonight by the Tigers and by the Vikings. So I think Ripon, we talked about it at halftime. I thought Ripon just did a better job of making the dynamic duo of Aiden Barr and Ethan Cole work a little more for a living, and their shots didn't fall as true as they did in the first half. And because of that, I think Ripon did a better job of ball distribution in their own half-court offense, found open players, and they dropped them in. And I think that was the difference of the game.
Well, you want to give Garrett Jennings from the Tigers some kudos because he really stepped up on Ethan Cole.
Yeah, as well as Schultz, and they would kind of trade off. Yep. They both did a great job. Made that very nice player, Ethan Cole, force some shots.
Took him out of his rhythm, for sure.
Yeah. So anyway, I want to say give a big thanks to our guys here, Chris Jones and Cole Gragney. They do a great job with the camera work. You people that are watching live streaming or on the delay broadcast on the Ripon cable channel, and then also Jason Mansmith, the guy that works the behind the
board.
Scenes, the board. I'm not even sure what that is. All I know is I've been told multiple times, Martin, you're never not only going to see it, you're not going to be allowed to go near it. So someone there should get a promotion for making that rule. And then also Athletic Director Bill Kinziger plays a great host here at the Tiger Den of Ripon High School. Executive Producer Riley Eisnagel. And then Howard.
Well, Marty Ernzer on color, and I'm Howard Hansen. It was a great game to call. I look forward to it. And we got a barn burner tonight, which was nice.
Yeah.
The Ripon Tiger Sport Network thanks you for your joining the broadcast of Ripon Tiger Sports on the Ripon Channel, Ripon Cable Channel 986, 93.1 FM and AM 1600 WRPM, your hometown stations. p.m., your hometown stations.